Students, today I am going to talk about an important question asked by UPSC in 2021. This question is from first paper and first question, that is animism and deep ecology, right? And this question for 10 marks, and we have write our answer in 150 words. So basically, when we are going to write answer about that question, first important thing is, most of students are familiar with the concept of animism, right? Because that concept mentioned in topic religion, and that concept was first developed by E.B. Tyler in his famous work Primitive Culture. Right? Primitive Culture, 1871, right? And in this Primitive Culture, E.B. Tyler said that belief in anima or soul is the early form of religion. Early form of religion. But animism is broad concept, because in animism we include all living and non-living object. According to animism, soul present in all living and non-living object in nature. So we respect all living and non-living object which present in our nature, because all are divine. Later there are development of concept of new animism in anthropology. New animism. So concept of new animism believe that all organisms have equal importance, equal respect, equal value in nature. All organisms have divine power. All objects are animate, and hence all objects are alive in nature. So we should give equal respect to all objects which present in our nature, our natural environment, or on our earth. So basically, in animism we give respect to our earth, our mountain, our river, our plant, our animal, all things. All things have equal importance as like human being. So this is the concept related to animism. But how this concept is related with the concept of deep ecology. So first, we try to understand about the concept of deep ecology. That concept was at first developed by Arne. Ness in 1973 in his famous work The Shallow and the Deep. Long range ecology movement, right? So Arne Ness developed that concept as a green ecological movement. But Arne Ness differentiate about shallow ecology and deep ecology. So he said that shallow ecology based on the theory of anthropocentrism means ecology or environment or nature for human being. So if we are facing some problems as a form of environmental pollution, environmental degradation, ecological imbalance, we should solve that problem by development of proper technology. We can reduce that problem for the benefit of human being. That is called shallow ecology. But he said that deep ecology is the based on the concept of ecocentrism. Ecocentrism. And he further developed two important concepts for the interpretation of deep ecology. That is, first, biospherical egalitarianism. Biospherical egalitarianism. And second is self-realization. Right? So when we try to understand about that two important concepts for the understanding of deep ecology, we can easily understand how that concept of deep ecology related with the concept of animism. How there is deep interrelationship between animism and deep ecology. So in biospherical egalitarianism, Arne Ness said that we should give equal value, equal right to all organisms in our nature, because all organisms have equal right to life. This is the basic concept. All organisms have equal right to life in nature, on earth, in environment. Right? And second, self-realization means identification of self with other. Here, identification of self with other means. He said that human being is a part of nature. So human being deeply associated with nature and all have equal importance in their nature, living, non-living. Even he described organism, living. He also described some non-living object are alive. They are similar, they are living, they are acting as like living element, like river, like mountains or other non-living object on our earth. So basic concept is that if we try to do betterment in the life of human being, we can do betterment of the life of human being on the basis of protection of ecosystem. Equal importance, we should give equal importance to all organism, we should give equal importance to all object which present in our nature. Because if we destroy forest, if we destroy animal, then human being suffering from pain. Because individual is a part of whole. We are the part of our nature. So hence, that concept develop as a deep ecology. Right? So when he said self-realization, he also tried to understand that the self is as like the part of soul. Right? That is related with whole. Soul is also related with whole in here in the concept of animism. So basically in both concept, animism and deep ecology, that give us two important things. We have give equal respect to all living and non-living object which are present in our nature. Second is, all organism have equal right to life as like human being. So human being is an important part of nature. So if we give right to life to human being, we should also give right to life in another animal being, even to plant also. So human can easily survive with the coexistence of another non-living and living object which present in our nature. So basically he explained that concept in holistic manner. Holistic perspective. So here in animism, if you try to understand about the concept of animism, and when we believe that everything have soul, so if everything has soul and we respect that soul as a divine power, we give equal importance to man and another organism in animism, and we also give equal importance to human and another organism. So both concepts are some similarity. Basically, that concept animism influence to Ernie Nassie for the development of deep ecology, because when he was in Himalayan mountain, he observed about the behavior of Sherpa community, and Sherpa treated Himalayan range as like living object. They give importance to that mountains as like living object. They think that that is the sacred thing in their life. They can better survive through that mountains. So he was influenced by that concept, and therefore he developed that concept, deep ecology. So both are interrelated with each other, but both have some differences also, because in animism, our focus is understanding relationship with man and their nature, their supernatural also. Here, through deep ecology, we can understand relationship with human, with their nature, right? And therefore, both have some differences. But after that, we can write there are some differences between the concept of animism and deep ecology. But both concepts are deeply interrelated with each other, both influence to each other. So we can better understand about the concept of animism and deep ecology together, right? And through that you can write your answer. So therefore UPSC has asked these types of questions, and through that you can write your answer.